Tennis in China. Tennis in China is a rapidly growing sport that has received much private and public support, and has today become firmly entrenched in the Chinese consciousness as one of the most popular. Tennis is now the third most popular sport on television in China, behind football and basketball. The national governing body is the China Tennis Association. China has 30,000 tennis courts, and an estimated 14 million people in China regularly play tennis, up from 1 million when the sport returned to the Olympics in 1988, according to the WTA Tour. The Chinese government is aiming to increase that by 15% every year. The nation's tennis market has reached $4 billion annually, according to experts. The Women's Tour upgraded the China Open in Beijing to become the only combined event with Men's Tour in Asia. Played at the Beijing Olympic Tennis Center with combined prize money of $6.6 million and a main stadium that hosts 10,000 spectators, the China Open is now one of WTA's top four tournaments. The ATP's other flagship tournament in Asia is the $3.2 million Shanghai Masters. Overview and history. Overall, there are four fundamental reasons that have contributed to the growth of tennis in China. Firstly, the national economy has improved enormously, and the booming middle class sees tennis as a family sport and a way to improve social status. Secondly, there has been the emergence of higher-ranked players from other parts of Asia, such as Japan, India, and Thailand, all of whom spurred competition and standard of play. Thirdly, the investment of the International Tennis Federation and the Chinese Tennis Association in the development of the grassroots game has been crucial. And finally, there are the Beijing Olympics, considered as a way to raise the profile of sport in China. When tennis became a fully-fledged Olympic sport, the government began to invest money in the sport. This became a trend in many parts of the world, such as Russia, Serbia, and Croatia. Funds were also secured to send teams of players overseas. The women's national team soon reached the elite group in the Fed Cup. With funding issues taken care of, the players and their coaches were able to concentrate totally on training and preparation. New programs were introduced for speed and stamina training, and for developing technical expertise. While Chinese women players dominate the scene today, it was the man who made the initial breakthrough. In 2003, at the Heineken Open in Shanghai, wildcards Zheng Shaoxuan and Zhu Benqiang made an important advance. They became the first players from China to reach a tour-level doubles final. Li Ting and Sun Tiantian won the doubles gold medal at the 2004 Athens Olympics. In 2006, more tennis history was written when Zheng Jie and Yan Zi won doubles at the Australian Open and Wimbledon. Li Na, at the same Wimbledon competition, became the first Chinese player to reach a Grand Slam singles quarterfinal, and also the first player from China to be ranked in the world's top 20. At Wimbledon in 2008, Zheng Jie became the first Chinese player ever to reach semifinals of the Grand Slam singles tournament, and in 2009, became the first Chinese player to be ranked in the world's top 15. During the 2010 Australian Open, Li Na and compatriot Zheng Jie made history for becoming the first two Chinese players to reach the top four of a Grand Slam tournament simultaneously. The media dubbed the players as two golden flowers, and many heralded their feat as a breakthrough for Chinese tennis. On January the 27th, 2011, a greater breakthrough was achieved by Li Na when she reached the singles final of the Australian Open. Some have suggested that this feat signals the emergence of China as a tennis power. Presented by Jian Yuli.